I'm Fiorenzo Dioni, Head of Engineering at IDRA, and today we're going to take a look at IDRA's latest addition, the patented 5S injection. S5 injection is an acronym for strong, simple, stable, smooth, and sustainable. This is an innovative system dedicated not only to the technological aspect, but also and above all to energy saving, with the application of a regenerative fluid system, as well as simplifying the management of maintenance parameters. What you see here is a 5S injection for a 2,700-ton machine. And you can clearly see how different it looks compared to the previous OLCS IDRA injection system. As has always been the case in the past, the project has been studied, but tested extensively in the field. In fact, the prototype has been in production for the last 3 years and is still in production today on a machine at our FSA, or Foundry Star Alliance partner, Co-Stamp Group. As you can see, the main differences compared to a classic injection are an additional cylinder mounted above the actual cylinder of the injection, and the total absence of the quick exhaust block, which managed the cycle in real time, based on the historic meter out concept. This system is an evolution of the unit already applied by IDRA on the Giga presses, which have given excellent results with castings weighing over 100 kilograms. On those machines, the original regenerative system and independent injection system are applied together. The 5S injection is a state-of-the-art system at the heart of the die casting process. It's a very strong injection that provides greater dynamic forces than all previous series, ensuring that even the most complicated molds can be filled with ease, speed, and the necessary force. Because some of the new molds are over 2 meters wide and require a high and very constant flow of molten metal. This system is optimal for large structural components that require a very long first phase, with consequent major emptying of the accumulators. With conventional classes, this means less dynamic force available when needed, due to the pressure delta. With the 5S, the accumulators are always loaded, and the second phase injects a higher dynamic force available, which is why the Giga presses make larger, high-quality parts. In technical detail, the additional cylinder we are talking about earlier, which we call a cushion, is a hydraulic shock absorber that manages the flow of hydraulic fluid exiting from the stem side of the injection, with a constant back pressure. And this is extremely important in this project. Fundamental for having a fluid movement of the injection from the first start of the first phase until the end of the stroke at speed. There are no pressure jumps at the start, and the fluid is not stressed, and therefore zero emulsion in the tank, and only one valve to manage everything. Speaking of the exhaust, in practice, the proportional speed control valve is no longer located in the exhaust block of the injection cylinder. In this way, we have removed many of the problems associated with turbulent flow and high pressure differential through the speed control valve in meter out. Then it works in meter in. This, in turn, results in smoother movement and less erosion, longer life for the valve, in this case TDP, but could be a TFP, and the injection cylinder itself. Maintenance of the injection system is very simple, as all the components are located in positions that allow the use of the overhead crane without necessarily having to enter the actual injection area, let alone having to go under the injection, where there are obviously rather unpleasant environments in the foundry, full of aluminium splinters, dirt, and so on. The pump. What we were saying before, the 5S injection system is a regenerative injection for both the first and the second phase, unlike the original, which only regenerated in the first phase, and allows us to reduce the energy consumption required for the time taken to recharge the accumulators. The unit is also equipped with an independent servo pump for recharging the accumulator. This allows us not so much to reduce the size of the power of the pump motors at the rear, let's say the main manifold of the machine, but to make them work less and only when necessary, thus saving energy. The injection motion, I repeat, features a very smooth startup and high force with precise closed loop control in real time. As a result of the regeneration of the hydraulic fluid, we use a relatively limited amount of pressure and flow from the second stage accumulator, greatly reducing the pressure drop we mentioned, and consequently have full power when we need it, as well as high speed. All this gives a clear indication of why those five S's that make up the name of the unit, which with the evolution of the casting to be produced has become the true heart of the GigaPress. In detail, that independent motor, called DCP, or drive control pump, will be equipped with the 5S injection on the new Neo series, equipped with this new over-the-edge drive control system developed by IDRA. The DCP has a new architecture which can achieve the same efficiency as previous machines with smaller and lower power motors. This is possible thanks to a new improved master-slave PLC control of accumulator charge on the 5S injection, which loads independently from the closing system, the ejectors and cores. This combination of factors guarantees an energy saving of 54% compared to what was fitted on the previous OLCS series.